The controversy all started with the decision not to host the grand launch of Carnival this year. The St. Lucia National Carnival Bands Association had been in a back and forth with the stakeholders committee over the issue. Matters of financing and budgetary allocations to Carnival also played a major role into the controversy over this year's festival.
The recommendation coming from within the stakeholders is for a little more permanence for the committee, whether it is for this committee as it is formed now, or whether it is a body that will be formed for that purpose. But I think we have reached a point in time where it is absolutely necessary that there is a body that is assigned to managing the festivals in St. Lucia, in particular our Carnival Festival, which runs for months, unlike any other festival that we have in St. Lucia. And we keep comparing it to jazz, which I think is unfair, but jazz really happens over a couple of weeks, whereas Carnival happens over a period of months.
According to the administrator of the Carnival Stakeholders Committee, even after the main festival culminates, other events will be hosted, such as community carnivals in Anslery, Groseley and Trozelle. Ms. Tobia highlights the need to manage the carnival product.
We really need to be able to manage that festival properly and bring it to the glory that it is. There are a lot of things that are happening this year that we hope will push for that to happen in the future, one of which, of course, there is the economic survey that is being done through the ministry right now on the economic impact of Carnival, and we're hoping that by the end of that process that we really can sit together and come up with a vision that takes the product forward.
The administrator of the Carnival Stakeholders Committee says presently the committee is in completion and execution mode. The Calypso quarterfinals will be held this week, and the registration for Soca Monarch has a Thursday deadline. In addition, there is no confirmed change to the carnival route. However, the Groovy and Power Soca Monarch competition will be combined, and the King and Queen of the Bands, which will stand alone, is slated for July 11th at the Coco Cabana grounds in Rodney Bay. For the DBS News World, Jason Hullingsed reporting.